Inside this video right here, I'm gonna go over one of my most frequently asked questions. When should you go to paramedic school? When should you go from EMT to paramedic? Let's dive into it. Hey everyone, it's the Paramedic Coach here. I'm so excited to deliver this video for you. Do me a favor, hit the like button down below, smash that like button. Someone hit that like button for you, so make sure to hit it for somebody else so that they can see this video here. And also hit subscribe as well for yourself so you can watch more videos like this and become great at EMS. Now, in today's video, I'm gonna be talking about when should you go and sign up for paramedic school. Time I'm shooting this video right now, I know August is coming up. August, January is a very popular time for paramedic schools to enroll new students. Here's the first thing, the first point. It is a personal decision, okay? Now I wanna tell you my story, it might motivate some of you. I was 19 years old when I started in EMS. So at 19, I went to EMT school. And then shortly thereafter, okay, with only 9 months of volunteer EMS experience, I'm in my first semester of paramedic school, okay? I was 20 years old. At the time, I hadn't even ran a cardiac arrest call yet. I remember the instructor saying, who here has ran a cardiac arrest? It was like me and like one other person, and it was never even at a code yet. So I didn't have a lot of experience, but what I was able to do, my little secret weapon, if you will, was about 2 to 3 months over that summer before it started in August, you know, May, June, July, while we were back at the base, I would just start studying, I coined it, pre-game studying. So studying the content like cardiology, like pharmacology, like prescription meds, like EMS meds, to start to get an awareness level of the content that paramedic school was going to throw at me first semester, second semester, AMP, before I went in. And I sat in the front of the class. I would record my instructor. And that's how I learned, okay, so this is how I learned, and I was able to pregame study. So that combination allowed me to do really well in paramedic school with not a lot of experience. During paramedic school, I was able, during the first semester, to get my first EMT job working in a high volume area, and the experience matched up with the paramedic school, able to graduate at 21 years old, I'm licensed paramedic. If I did it, why can't you? Maybe somebody right now is telling you, oh, you know, you're too young, or oh, you know, you don't have enough experience yet. That decision is up to you. If I did it, why can't you? Now let's talk more on specifics and certain situations and what to do. Let's dive into that. One of the biggest things you need to know about paramedic school is that the school is extremely accelerated. Why? Again, practice what you preach, right? This is why I pregame studied before I went in. This is why it's so important to pregame study before you enter paramedic school, no matter what your experience level is. Now, if you are someone considering, should I go from EMT to paramedic? The first thing is this. You need to make sure your friends, your family, and your life is in order and you're back into school mode. Meaning, you need to have your schedule squared away, you know, with work, with family, with friends. They need to know that for the next 14 months, 18 months, 2 years, depending on how you do it, right? You're gonna be hyper-focused on your career. You gotta have that going in. And you want to have somebody in your corner because times are going to be tough, right? It's going to be a lot of work. You might not do well in a test. You might do great in a test, ups and downs. It's normal. It's part of school, but you got to get ready for that. The second piece is if you are an EMT right now, and this happens very commonly, you're an EMT, you know you want to be a paramedic. That was me, okay? I told you my story. If you're not even volunteering right now, you haven't gotten the EMS operations down pat, you've never even made a radio patch or assessed a patient, you gotta get that going. That's gonna be very important. Because even though I didn't have a lot of experience before I went in, I still had 9 months of experience. I assessed patients, I did radio patches, right? I still had some experience. So you do wanna get that. So what I tell you is this, if you're applying like crazy to jobs as an EMT, great, continue that. But find a volunteer ambulance service. You know, I remember driving 30 to 40 minutes away just to volunteer one day a week, sometimes 2 days a week, right? When I first started, my recommendation to you is that you want to get some sort of EMS experience before you go in. Now, the third most important piece to this could be possible, it might not be possible, is try to work more ALS shifts. What I used to do with when I would have an EMC partner and I was the paramedic, what I would do is when I brought on a new EMT, let's say it was a new EMT partner, I would train them up to know and understand all of the ALS equipment in the back of the ambulance. So we'd go back there and we would go over NEBS. You know, we'd go over, make sure they're comfortable with CPAP, all of the EMS medications, right? Understanding the different IVs, going over some EKGs, right? Looking at EKGs together after the call, why I did this versus that. We'd talk in great length about those things while I knew that they had paramedic school coming up in a few months. So by the time they went in, they were prepared. That process motivated me to start the paramedic coach. This is exactly the stuff that I've done and put together when I talk about on-the-job tips, right, in my course. My whole goal with the paramedic coach video study course, that's the first link in the description down below, you can get lifetime access, is I want to be that mentor to you. I want to prep you for getting ready for paramedic school. You might not have somebody out there in your community, in your area that has that, but if you go through the video study course and you watch all the videos, 400 videos, content, imagine what you're gonna learn. It's essentially like having me with you in the ambulance with you on demand, but you can watch me whenever you want. That's the goal. If I give you one big recommendation for paramedic school, it's grab that course down below and start going through the EMS medications, the anatomy and physiology, the EKGs, the 12-lead EKGs. You can literally know your drug cards before you go in. This is why I work so hard on this course, so that you can be best prepared and not scrambling around like I was literally like back in the bunk room. People go, what is that crazy guy doing? No experience studying. I want you to be squared away. That's why I work so hard on this. And my friends, hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments down below what you are doing. Are you getting ready for paramedic school? Are you in now? Are you an EMT? Let me know. My friends, hope you enjoyed this video. I will see you on the next one. Peace out.
Don't waste any time. Don't be hesitant and just do it, because I know this program works. And I know it got me to where I was, where it's been a year without school, from EMT to, hey, I passed my test in 70 questions. Like, go for it. You could do it. Like, do not hesitate and don't waste any time.
People that don't know you, they need this program. This program is not a choice. To me, this program is a habit.
You take thousands and thousands of pages in the books and you just narrow it down and just make everything simple past the registry. So it's great content, man. I promise you, it's worth it.
Took this with 3 weeks left to go in my class, and I'm not sure if I would have been able to pass my course or the NREMT first try without this course.
The fact, like, when I was taking the national, and I would read the question and I would be like, whoa, Evan literally just went over this in the car. So it really helps.
I got to the point where I was just ready to spill all my knowledge onto this freaking test. So I'm like, you know what, man, just go ahead, go for it. Open it up, boom, congratulations, you passed. It was outside of having my children, man, it's probably like the happiest day of my life, bro, to be honest with you.